void change, fine. And you can see that I am sending an integer value, therefore here I will integer x. Change, okay. I have invoked the function m and m will be assigned to x, fine. Now here what I am going to do is x plus plus. I am making only one statement here, x plus plus. Okay. X plus plus we have done, fine. And then here I am finding printf. Even if I want, I can do in a different way so that you know you will. I am defining same variable here. Change m. I am calling the function here. Change integer m. Okay. Now here m plus plus. Okay. The value of printf. Print of the value of m is percentage d m. Okay, the value of m is percentage d m. Now we are closing the function. We are closing the function here. Now, so this function is over. That is, we are calling the functions after scanning. After scanning the value of m, I am calling this function. Comes to this place, this is executed, and afterward it is coming here. So after doing this, this printf statement will be executed, again it will come, again this printf will be executed. Then it calls the next function change using pointer. So let us see what will happen, or what exactly this function is, how to define this function. So here the function is to be defined like this. Again, it is a void function. Void change using pointer. Okay, here integer pointer k. Integer pointer k. Okay. Now, here it is pointer k. Plus plus, or here again let me we will define. Let us use m itself. Then only it will become, the program will be slightly funny. That is pointer m plus plus. Pointer m plus plus. Now printf, that is printf the value of m is, the value of m is percentage d, okay, pointer m. Now this program is to be very clearly analyzed from top to bottom in order to understand what exactly is happening. Let us look at this point, that is scan of percentage d and m. Change m, the function is calling, the function is being invoked from here, change m, and you can see that here void change integer m. Here also there is a, that is variable. Now one thing is to be very clearly understood. This m belongs to this. The m which I have defined in the main program belongs to this function only. That is a local, which is called a local variable. That variable is local and it belongs to that function only. It has nothing to do outside the function. So what happens is, this function, the scope of this variable, that is how we say that, the scope, the jurisdiction, the area of that variable m is only within this program, within this particular function. When you come out of that program, this has no value. That is, you can send the value contained by M. Okay. So what we are doing is, what is happening basically is, change M. Now this M will be assigned to, that is this M is another M. Okay. This M is a second M. That is, this M belongs to the main function. That is, the M in which there is a 55 belongs to the main function. Now when I am calling change M, okay, the value of the M in the main function is sent to this function. Again you have another M. This may even have another base address 200. Even though the name is same, the second M belongs to the function change. It's a different M. Now what is happening here? I am calling the function change M. Therefore what will happen? A copy of 55 was sent from here. Therefore here also I get 55. That is, the M of this particular function, that is, this M belongs to the main function and this M belongs to the function change. Okay. This M belongs to the function. That is, even though we are using the same name, it will have a different location. That is to be very clearly understood. Therefore, now what will happen? Let us see. 55 has come here. Okay. That is, M, the variable M which is belonging to the this particular function change gets the value 55. Now M plus plus, when I do M plus plus, do not think that this and this will get incremented. No, because that M is a local M. That M belongs to the function change only. Therefore, when we do M plus plus, here this will become 55 will become 56. 55 will become 56. Now, when this particular printf statement is executed, printf, the value of M is percentage DM. So naturally it will print the value of M is, so the first output which you get will be the value of M is 56. So this is the first output which you get. The first output which you get is the value of M is 56. But please keep it in mind here that M belongs to this, the function change. The function change contained, the value contained by M which belongs to the function change. Fine. Now, after printing this function, what happens? After printing this function, the control goes back. That is, we invoked the function from here. The call was made from here. Okay. The whole program is over. Once the program is over, it will come back to the next statement which immediately follows change. After the function is over, the control always goes back, even whether there is a return statement or not. That is immaterial. The control will go back. So now the control is coming back here. Okay. Here, printf, the value of M is %ADM. So here, when it comes back to the parent function from where the function was made. Now when you reach here, again you can see that M has no value here. That M perishes. That M dies off. It is dead. Once you come out of that function, all the variables, all the local variable belongings to that function becomes dead. Therefore, this variable gets dead when you come out of this function. Okay, you are coming over here, print off the value of m, that is the function is completely over. When the function is completely over, all the variable will be run. Whereas you have a function, the control goes back to somewhere else, this function is over, not over, you have some more remaining statement. In that case, yes, the status quo will be retained there. That will be taken care of by the operating system, that you will study in due course of time. So here, the control comes back here, print up the value of, so value of m is %m. Here, it will print the value of data. Therefore, the second output which you get could will be value of m is 55. So, for the second output, the second print of print statement, that is the value of m is 55, that m basically belongs to the main program, main function. That is why it is 55, it is printing the value of that m. Fine. So that is over. So this is the second output. Now what is happening here? You are calling the function, you are calling another function, change using pointer and m. Again, please keep it in mind, here I am passing the address of an m. Which m? The m which is belonging to this function, and that is this one. Okay. So, when I call this function, change pointer and m, which is again assigned to another m, so you can see that it is a third m. There is one more m which is a pointer variable, which is a pointer variable, and you can see that change pointer and m, the address of this m is sent, the address of this m is sent. So basically what is happening is here I am getting the value 100. So all the three m's are different. The third m is not, the third m is a pointer variable. Now it is getting the address of the m which is belonging to the main function, and m is getting the value 100. Okay. So now you are coming here. Now what is happening? The statement which I am doing is pointer m plus plus. But you can use, you will find that using that term you will access this m. How come? Pointer m, m is containing 100, pointer m means you go to the location 100, whatever be the value, whatever, okay, whatever is in that location, and that location is to be incremented, okay. That is by pointer m means, you can see, fine, pointer m plus plus, this is not plus m, it is pointer m plus. That is, here this m contains 100. Pointer m, you go to the location 100, you are going to a location 100, and the value contained in that location is incremented by one unit, pointer m plus plus. Therefore, basically this is becoming 56. Basically that is becoming 56. Now, what you are doing? Print off the value of m is %d pointer m. What is pointer m? Point by pointer m means the value contained at the location 100. So here when I do this, you can see that this will get 56. So here this printf statement will print 56. Print of the value of m is %ad. So this will print 56. So the third output which you are getting is the value of m is 56. So basically what you are, you can see that here using the third m we are accessing the first m. Okay. So this is the first m which was belonging to the this variable, this function. This m was belonging to this function, and the third m was a pointer variable m which was belonging to the third function, change using pointer. Now using the third m we could manipulate the first m, whereas using the second m we could not manipulate the value of first m, because it is a local, it is just a local variable. Here we were simply sending a copy of that. Okay. Therefore, we could not change the value. Now, here the value was changed. Fine. Now, after printing this, again the control is coming back. So, from here, the control was coming to this point, and once the function is over, here again you will come. Now, again, print off the value of m is percentage m. So, again, this m belongs to the first. This m is belonging to the main function, but the main function we have already changed using the other variable. Therefore, the fourth output will also be 56. The value of m is 56. So, now you must have understood how effective a pointer is. That is, using pointer means a variable which contains an address. Okay, and that is, if you have a pointer, using the content of that pointer or using the address contained by that pointer, you can go to a location and that value can be processed from a remote place. So that is the advantage of call by reference. We will take one more example and elaborate this discussion. Here, what I am going to do is, we are going to interchange two values and let us see what will happen. Here I will take, we will read two values in the main program and we will pass these values to a function, and then subsequently we will pass the address of these two variables to another, to a function where some processing will be done. And let us see what will happen in both the cases. That is, here also I will be incorporating two functions. Two functions will be there, in which one function will pass, it will be an invocation of a function by value, called by value function, and followed by a function in which reference will be done, that reference will be made, a call by reference function. So again, let us start writing the program. Okay, here a main program will be there and there will be two functions we are going to write. So from here I will start the main program and the other thing we will write on the right hand side, #include stdio.h, okay, and then void main, okay. You should have a clear plan, then only you will be able to define the integer variables and whatever functions are, that is declaration of variable, declaration of functions. You should plan in advance, then only you will be able to declare and then define them. So here the flow of the program will be like this. We will define two integer variables in the main program, two integer variables. The values to these integer variables will be fed, that it will be read. You will read values for these integer variables from the keyboard. Subsequently, these values will be passed, values will be sent to a function, where something will be done. You can do some interchanging of these values and again you will come back to the main program. And once you come back to the main program, again the function will be called, wherein we will send the address of these two variables. Address of these two variables will be sent, and using the address we will do something in the second function. So basically we'll be incorporating two functions in this program. Okay, so here I have integer x, y, fine, two integer values, and another function is I have a void function, void interchange integer. Again, I hope I don't have to explain this more. That is, this is a void function. That means this function is not returning any value. It is not returning any value to the calling point. Name of the function is interchange. It is taking two integer values. It will send two integer values to the function. Fine. Now, the second function is like this, void interchange p. That is, here I am using, that is interchange using pointer. So here integer pointer. So this is a data type which you are sending. That is those things which you have written within the brackets means that is the kind of data. It is a data type which we will be sending to the function. Here when I write integer, these are the two data which we will be sending, and the type of the data is integer. Integer pointer means we are sending pointer, that is address we will be sending. Okay, so that is now let us read values to x and y. So printf enter two integer values. Okay, slash n. Now we are reading values. Scanf percentage d and x and y. So through this statement we are reading values to x and y. Okay, we are reading values to the variables x and y from the keyboard, and after reading the values, fine, we can give a printf the value of x and y are, okay, the value of x and y are percentage d x y. The values of x and y are percentage d x y. So whatever you have entered through the keyboard will be printed, because we have not invoked any function. The same value will be printed. Now we are going to call the function interchange. So calling of the function will be like this: interchange x y. Interchange x y, it goes, the control goes to the function,